Okay, in round two here with our 80 cod deck, I'm gonna keep this. Hell, I have an Ornithopter. I have a Satyr Wayfinder. Yeah. These cards are very playable. honestly, I probably keep any hand. There's so many lands in this deck, and it's all random anyway, but this is actually pretty decent because I'll be able to at least cast the Sentinel on turn three and kind of like hang out till we can develop the board. If the Wayfinder finds an island, which would be already got an island, we'd be in pretty good shape. Boom, Ornithopter, casting you like the mofo you are. Depending on what my opponent does, I might just get the Welkin turn down, turn two. Yeah, let's aggro it out, friendos. Let's make this flying beastie thing happen. We'll have plenty of time for Satyr Wayfinder later. Ornithopter could be good with military intelligence. Again, there's two in this huge build, so. Nidcaster Spider. Bummer. Shutting down the Welkin turn. Unless I put a Divine Favor on it. Oh, wait, no, it still shuts it down. Bummer. What do I want to do? Play a 3-drop, right? A Gargoyle Sentinel, mayhaps? At least he can block the Nidcaster Spider then. Yeah, then next turn we can play Wayfinder into another 2-drop. Yeah. Unless I want a Coral Barrier for some reason. Yeah, let's do the Coral Barrier. Maybe my opponent's playing Islands. I could start a beatdown game plan. Also helps with Convoke. Come on. Cast. Thank you. No attacks. Opponent's still just on green. Big old drop coming down. Yes. Another Nidcaster. Okay, so our flyers aren't going to do a whole lot. Good to know. Swiftclaw can start pounding through it. Oh, but we do have military intelligence, so this Ornithopter might get to cycle once we attack in with something else. Still, the game plan is to try to dig for an island. I will go ahead and play, or keep the blue up in the event I want to play military intelligence right away. Don't know if I'm going to want to do that. Is there planes? Do I get a planes for my Swiftclaw? I do get a planes for my Swiftclaw. Nice. So that worked out pretty handily, I'd have to admit. Rightio then. Alright, my 4-color deck is working! Woohoo! And a 5-drop. A charging rhino! Do I have any way to deal with that? I guess I put a Divine Favor on my Swiftclaw. Remember, I just want to stay alive. That's like my only goal. Till I can get to a bomb. I can't believe I'm playing these cards. I can't believe I can cast these cards. Do I just play the Accursed Spirit? Here. The rhino starts coming through. I'm tempted to put the Divine Favor on the Swiftclaw. Just to get a 4-4. Try to trade the rhino. No, I'm just gonna put a threat out. We're not going to lose the race too much that way. And maybe we'll cycle again the Mishage with the Ornithopter next turn. See how that goes. So my opponent figured out that I just have the wonkiest deck in the world. Oh, white. Okay. I'm a little scared. It's a powerful set of cards. Right, taking 4. We'll be able to chump away when we need to later on. Gosh. Well, green was pretty open, so this is the person who went and grabbed all of them dudes. Attacking with a Cursed Spirit. And the Swiftclaw. My opponent wants to trade the Spider and that, then I'm okay with it. I have blockers for these dudes. And we just get to cycle cards at that point. I don't think I'm going to put the Divine Favor on the Accursed Spirit. even though it does get me an extra point of damage in. I think I want to diversify where I end up putting it, so I'm going to wait since I'm not going to get extra damage in, and kind of see where that takes me. Clear a path. I don't have any defenders. So funny. Yeah, my boss's like, yeah, we'll trade. Why not? Which is good. I'll probably just be cycling a lot of cards, like paying three, attacking the Sentinel and the Cursed Spirit next turn. We're still taking some damage, but I'm not super worried about it. Again, we can start chumping when we need to. I just want to get a board state that's decent. Sure, I can't take four for forever. And it might be like I just put a Divine Favor on the Gargoyle Sentinel now. Ooh, Amphin Pathmage. Amphin Pathmage makes things a whole lot nicer. I am tempted to put the Divine Favor on the Gargoyle Sentinel. I do want to be drawing a card every turn, so I think this is now time to get rid of the Ornithopter. And then that way, at least the Sentinel can block the Rhino. My opponent has to have something to deal with it. Yeah. All right. Attacking it with the Cursed Spirit and the Ornithopter so we can draw our card. What do we get? Another land. I want four, so that's the case, because I want to be able to cast the Hornet Queen should I get it, but would've. Do I even have mountains in my deck? I don't know. I have no idea if I have mountains in my deck. It's okay, we'll cycle it away from the other, on our next guy. Yay, life! This will go a long way to drawing us some cards. Oh man, you would have a Reclamation Sage. What a bummer. I had a little bit of hope that I could get out of this game. Now I have zero hope. I'm still taking four. I'll still do that. I'll take my four. Because we're going to attack in for six next turn, draw a card, and then we'll start chumping after that, I think. That seems a little bit better then. Okay. Could have waited to do that after a different step, but let's just get it on. My opponent has one card, that's probably land. Research Assistant. Of course, I can't cast it. I'm gonna start chumping away though. I'm fine with that. We'll Satyr Wayfinder and the Squid can chump into the Charging Rhino. I'm not gonna play the Plains. I might actually be able to get the Research Assistant going. I don't know. I don't think there's gonna be enough time in the game for that, but it could happen. Ooh, opponent grabs. Ooh, Evasive Species. Okay. A little bit of pressure. Am I able? If I draw planes, I might be able to win here. Nope. There goes a military intelligence. Well, actually, I could still win if I draw planes. Phone has a lot on the crackback. Planes? Pillar of Light. Not bad. Not bad at all. One, two, three. So we're still going to attack in for six. What's the crackback looking like? This guy's gonna be gone. Block. I mean, I guess block. This guy can't block at all. So I'm taking one, two, three, four, five, maybe? Yeah, we're in good shape. We're in decent shape. Jeez. just might get there. Attack! Is there anything that my opponent could have that makes Pillar of Light not happen? Not in those colors. So I'm not... Normally you just want to wait. Or not wait. Not let my opponent draw the out, if you will. There could definitely be like pumps and stuff, but that I can't deal with. Okay. There's the attacks. Yes, they are. So now we go to blocks. You're going to trade... I think I need you to do more blocking over here. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 damage. Yep. That guy's out. This guy's traded. What else you got? Yay! Ha ha! 80 card deck's getting there again. Is this the new strategy in drafting? Is this the new limited strategy? I don't know. Okay, and we're back to the base build. Once again, I want to decide how do I want to do this. Selfless Cathar, Divine Favor. I don't think anything else I want. My opponent hoses all of my flyers. Those 2/3 are going to be annoying, but at least the Geist do trade. It doesn't make the Cathar any better. The Divine Favor... I just need like a Hornet Queen down, huh? This guy will be good. I mean, honestly, I only won because of some of this evasion from my other colors. I wonder if that's even better. I still don't think I rely on that chance against my opponent. I think we keep that going. It means I do want to be playing... ways to kind of like maybe put a Divine Favor on a ground guy, the Pride Mate, or like a Midnight Guard to bash through the 2/3s on the ground. Yeah, I don't think the Selfless Cathar is going to be good enough. So we're bringing that Divine Favor again on the sideboard. Interesting. Let's see how this 40. Oh, we got a keep, alright. Got our bomb in hand. A 1/2/3 drop if we draw the second planes is nice. At the very least, we're not getting run over. Which is kind of a big deal for my deck. Oh, let me get to maybe draw a card. Alright, Hornet Queen. You are my goal. Seder Wayfinder? You would. You would, Seder Wayfind. What's been revealed? Forest again. Oh, yay, a spider's gone. I like that. I like that a lot. Opponent has a forest in hand. Good to know. I'm going to attack with my Selfless Cathar, because I don't need it for Convoke or anything. And I actually want the Satyr trade with it and get the Swift Claw down next. Cool. Venom Star. Oh, another one? You got another guy? That's okay. Not great, but it's okay. Come on. Yep. I could have boarded out the Gargoyle Sentinel, but I don't have better options to bring in, so that's where I have barely playables, and then this happens. But because we saw 2 Reclamation Sages main decked, by the way. Land? No. Ranger's Guile? Not great, but a thing. I really want another land to get this Shaman going, but we just gotta hang out for a little while, it would seem. Opponent wants to start bashing for 2. I feel ya, opponent. I feel ya. I really want the Swift Claw around because of the spiders and a lot of the 3 toughness dudes. I wanted to be able to trade for all the 3 toughness guys. Hey! Fourth land. Yay! We're just looking to go to Value Town now. We get to the White Queen. That's the entire game plan. Hey, we got a land. That's nice. Take a while before we can really make use of it. We'll start making trade-offs. Happy to do that. I don't think my opponent will start going that route, but I'm down. These guys can pretty much trade. So what is this? Sanctified Charge? If that's the case, do I just make my opponent do it? Yeah, if my opponent wants to do a Sanctified Charge to save a Reclamation Sage, I'm okay with that. I think I'm going to keep the Swift Claw around, though. Invasive Species. I assume bouncing, what, Spider, just because there's the mana? Why not? Lands are good. Do I play the Marked by Honor to get a 5-3 and then have Ranger's Guile up to try to block one of these guys? That seems kind of horrible. I think we want to put it on an evasive dude like this later on. So we'll just keep having this Swift Claw hold down the fort. Whilst we try to draw into more game stalling tactics while we get the Hornet Queen mana ready to rock. Here, I will go ahead and put the Swift Claw in front of the Netcaster Spider. Hold on, how much? It gets three. It only gets one extra time. Yeah, so we can still do that. And again, the Spider I care more about because we're going to try to win through evasion at some point. Okay. We're getting beats downs. Shaman's Ring. Ooh, that's not good. That was my opponent to draw more action. I think a Plains would be an okay draw here. We need to draw something to put a defense up. Plains is good. We have a couple more turns still, though. It's going to be rough. Right now, the Geist is our main defensive plan. We're going to keep around with Ranger's Guile for no matter what. We're taking 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We're down to 6, which means any pump gets us. But I think we have to let it go through and then put a Marked by Honor on it if we're hoping to win this. Is there a Sanctified Charge? I don't think my opponent has it. I think my opponent was bluffing it earlier. That's nice. I do like that a lot. Oh, hold on. Doesn't matter. 1, 1, 2, 3. Marked by Honor on this guy. We attack. But we have Ranger's Guile to protect, so we're okay. I was going to say, might want to play around removal spell, but we're okay. Nice. We'll play our land. Play our Venom Sliver. Which will trade with anything at this point because we're at such low life. Well, maybe not its own Venom Sliver or Mystic, but one of these guys. Ugh, Reclamation Sage. Do I just let this guy? I think I need to protect the Marked by Honor. If my opponent had something else, I think it would have gone down. The thing is, it only. What do I want to do? Sure, you're targeting that. I think I do play it. I think I play the Ranger's Guile. Oh, but no, it doesn't do anything. Whoa, that would have been bad. Because it's targeting. Shoot, shoot. Well, unfortunately, I signal that I have Ranger's Guile, and there's not a whole lot I can do about that now. And now that I tapped the mana poorly, that could be really bad. So you're going here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Down to 2. I think I just have to block. I've got a 4. My opponent is lethal on the board, though. But it gives me the most outs. Indestructible? Gather courage. Okay. Well, at least I'm alive. Does a Hornet Queen get me? Come on, one land. Just a land. Boom! No! So close, yet so far. We had one land. Wait! Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh, I'm such an idiot. Why are you guys even watching me play right now? Hornet Queen is 7, not 8. I so deserve to lose right now. You guys gotta be shouting so hard at the screen. Ah, that is hilarious in the worst possible way. So, probably would have won if I had, really paid attention to my Hornet Queen's casting cost. Why did I think it was 8? I don't even know. Keeping the same way. Selfless Cathar does not seem grand here. Divine Favor, I think I need a way to pump up. End of a format, by the way. Well, we'll keep. Look, we got our combo. How frustrating, though. Yay, no Mystic. That's very good. We'll go on the aggressive here. Get the Pride Mate into the Midnight Guard if possible. Then we'll put our defenses up afterwards. Maybe get some damage through. Do you have your own Sliver? No, Rune Cloud Bear. Okay. Will I trade my Pride Mate? I don't know. Do I use a Ranger's Guile here? My opponent doesn't give the option. Love it. If I can magically wait for this Venom Sliver to come after the Constricting Sliver. Ooh, yeah. Netcaster Spider. Not surprised. My opponent has 3 of them at least, probably 5 in the deck. Mass Calcify? Oh. Now, this also only costs 7, not 8, so I do want to remember that. I will attack with the Midnight Guard. Or will I? Sure, my opponent can double block. But my opponent let that go through, so I'm actually okay with that. Because I want that spider gone. And then, I think I do hang on to the Venom Sliver. Let my opponent think there's something valuable to be played out, and we'll get the defense back on. Paragon. Uh-oh. I guess I do want the Venom Sliver. Yeah, we'll just double block. I'm cool with that. The Geist! Again, we're missing our second guy. Well, we have no attacks now. I'm just, right now, I have blocks, so I don't mind waiting on the Venom Sliver because there's such an upside with the Constricting Sliver. I'm okay with it. Also, we might get Mass Calcify before anything else. Ooh, hello, Convoke Siege Worm. Alright, Venom Sliver has to come down now. If I was closer to the Mass Calcify mana, then fine, but we're gonna take a lot of damage from this anyway, but I wanna at least kill it when that happens. Getting closer. Play both. Not attacking. Take a lot of damage, but we have decent blocks otherwise. Opponent's going for it. We've seen the +2/+2. We haven't seen a Sanctified Charge. If that becomes a 5/5, that's bad. I think we just take a huge hit right now. Could put the Geist there. Force the card to go. We still take a lot of damage though. So if you go 3/4/5, 3/4, it's gonna be a 2/2. 3/4/5. Yeah, let's go for it. If my opponent wants to trade the flyer for that, I'm okay with it. We just want to get late to this guy. Alrighty. Shaman of Springs, not great, but 2/2s don't do much. 3/3s, we can double block. Venom Sliver. Okay. Divine Favor. Well, how about that? We can make a huge dude on the Pride Mate, which is kind of nice. In that, I mean, I'm still thinking two from the Sliver, but I'll just trade the Midnight Guard for, and then we have a nice big old dude just to keep things hanging out, and that might be our big finisher later. Yes, please. And then our next land we draw, we get our Constricting Sliver to take out whatever other big beefy dude comes down. And then later on, we'll have our Mass Calcify, which will just be great as long as we get to keep one of our threats around, which is the game plan. Right, Invasive Species. Big ol' 4/4. Bouncing Shaman. Next turn, that'll kill the Divine Favor. I'm not excited for. But maybe the Constricting Sliver will have. Okay. So, what do I do? The Divine Favor's gone next turn. No matter what. So, who goes away? I'll still have a 3/3 on the table. Think we just get rid of the Invasive Species? If I get rid of the Venom Sliver, I can attack with the Pride Mate. My opponent can double block. Then I'm trading not awesome stuff, but at least some trades. I don't really want to do that because I just kind of want to go late. The thing is, I don't have a great way to deal with the invasive species as a 4/4. I'm going to have a 3/3. Oh, I guess I do. Maybe it's the Venom Sliver, though. But I can take two for a while. Yeah, let's just take the invasive species, take the pressure off of me, and then soon enough, I'll be able to mass calcify. This just lets me buy the time I need to get to my next to the seventh land. I have 6 minutes left, something to note. Yeah, I want to use that ability. Give her here, honey. So Reclamation Sage will take the Primate out, but I still have a 3-3. If the Venom Storm wants to attack in, I'll probably just take the damage. I'm in high enough life total right now. If we rip a land off the top, these guys all go away. And then we just bash through for 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It'll be pretty nice. Be in good position. Opponent just wants to hang out. Hey, how about that? I'm just going to go for it. I don't think there's any reason to wait. There's nothing in these colors like a counterspell to get it. And since the Reclamation Sage didn't take out the Divine Favor, we're in really good shape. Would not be excited if the Constricting Sliver goes away, but whatever. Which means I'm probably only attacking with these two guys, keeping the Constricting Sliver back, because there is that pump spell. Because that's how we lose. Right, 7 mana rare, get there, since I didn't let it happen last time. Did we get there again? We did. I can't believe we're in the finals! Not only do I have a silly 80 card starting deck, I also don't know how to cast the best bomb in the entire format. Thanks for sticking out this long if you have already and not rage quitting while watching. Let's get to the finals.